Yeah, so now let's see about this Appium desktop. Okay, so go back to your Safari browser and say download Appium desktop. So till in the last lecture we have seen running on starting an Appium server with just node version, like we just hit Appium and then server starts in a command prompt. That is command, you know, non-UI tool. We are just starting it from command line. We have also seen Appium GUI, where on the top right we used to click start server and the logs will begin. And apart from that, Appium guys came up with a new version called Appium Desktop. Okay, let's see that. Go to download Appium, and this is the latest release. And when you click on here, okay, so Appium Desktop for Mac, Appium Desktop. So as it is Mac, it pre-populated me with this. Just download this. Okay, so if you are working on Windows, maybe you can use this .exe file for setting that up. Okay, for Mac right now, you can download this zip file and click on the .exe file. Okay, so once it is done, you will see something like this. Yeah, here you go. So please move that from downloads to applications folder, okay, or any other folder from downloads, right? So if you try to open this, the Appium desktop, and this is how you see. So let me stop the server. And this is not the initial page because I already started earlier. So let me start it again from launchpad. So initially it will be in downloads. So I just moved it into the Appium. Okay, it's trying to open. Yeah. So this is how it looks. So earlier when we are working with command line Appium, we just used to type Appium. That's it. The server will start. That is one way. And I also taught on some Appium GUI 2 lectures where on top right I used to click on start server so that in a black screen logs will begin and server starts. That is another way. So Appium guys has came up with one more way. This is the latest style of starting the server. They just provided us Appium desktop. Okay, so host and port will already be here. I mean, with some more rich UI. Okay, just enhancement of existing. So they'll keep on changing it. Tomorrow they might come up with again one more desktop. In that desktop, start server may be here. Okay, so core functionality is same. Just we are starting the server. But the buttons, the layout, they keep on changing for, you know, better look. So let's start the server. Start server. Hit on this link. Right. It said welcome to Appium. That means server is started. So what uniquely this tool provides compared to Appium GUI and other command line less tools, or here Appium provides object inspector. Remember in Android to inspect objects we used Android UI automator. Okay, so for iOS what do you use? Okay, so Apple did not provide any tool like Android for object inspection. Okay, Android guys have as UI automator with which we happily got the objects. But whereas in iOS, Apple did not expose any such kind of tool. For that reason, Appium guys came up with their own Appium inspector in this tool to inspect the objects in the iOS. Okay, you can use this inspector even for Android. But still, I would suggest you to go with UI automator tool only, because that is provided by Android guys and it is more stable in identifying the objects than Appium. Okay, because that's an original tool. So let's stick to that for accurate results. But for iOS, as we are not having any other option, we are going to depend on Appium Inspector. Right. So you can start, server is automatically started when you click a button and you can stop the server with this. Okay, so now question is, how do you inspect objects with Appium? okay, from this tool. So before that, let's start creating our test case and let's complete the desired capabilities writing in our test. Once they are written and the app is invoked successfully, and then we will come back and then start inspecting the objects to prepare test cases, right? So let's go back and download Eclipse to begin our tests. As I told you in the Android lectures, just go and say Eclipse download and open it, because I have already discussed how to download Eclipse. There is nothing different in Mac or Windows. It's all about downloading the Eclipse and unzipping that file. Okay, so still I can show you where exactly you have an. Download Eclipse. Yeah, this is the link. So here, rather than directly downloading this, just say download packages and download this. Eclipse IDE for Java EE developers. That's it. Download this and invoke that. You will see eclipse.exe. You will see eclipse.dmg here. Okay. So let me show you how it looks in my download section. So it will come with .tar extension. Double click that and you will see, let me show you the icon like this. Okay, Eclipse. I just moved that file into my application folder. Okay, just double click that and this file will be generated, and just open this file and where you will be prompted to the Eclipse. So you are very familiar with this, isn't it, from last few sections. And I strictly say that please go through the Android installation, everything, before coming to this section, because I'm not going to again explain how to create a project or how to import Appium jars inside it, because we have already taken enough time to discuss all those. I just don't want to waste time in increasing the lecture's duration by again teaching the same thing. Okay, so if you do not know how to set up a Java and how to create a project and how to import Appium Java client jars into it, just go through that. So it's again same. So what I have done, I have created a project just like my Android section, and we need to import jars, right? Appium and Selenium jars, and I have done that. That's it. So if you see, let me right click here and go to properties, Java build path, and you see that I have imported all the Appium as well as Selenium jars. That's it. You see that Java client, this is an Appium jar, and remaining all are Selenium jars. You know where to get all these, because we have deliberately taken and explained in our Android setup. Okay, so if you have any doubt, just go back to that lecture, and all set. So Eclipse is ready, and project we are already having because I created it earlier. So let me go back to my Word document. We have successfully built the iOS app, and we have downloaded Appium desktop, and we started our Appium server. We have downloaded Eclipse and created a project as well. And the next, the only step left is to start writing test case. Okay. In the next lecture, let's complete writing desired capabilities for iOS app, and then we can start from there. Okay. Thank you.